wanna say thank you for the way you love me. I wanna say thank you for the way you love me. I just wanna say thank you for the way you love me. I wanna say thank you, just wanna say thank you. Yeah, THANKYO, you thank you.
Thank you.
THANKYO, you thank you.
Well, hey everyone, welcome back. I am so thankful to see all of you here this morning. I know this week must have been really difficult for you with having to change things for a little while, but you've pushed through it and you should be very proud of the work that you are doing. If you're new with us this morning, welcome to Unity Kids! This year has been kind of crazy, and so we've taken some time each week to sit down and talk about life, love, and how Jesus is a part of all of that. We've been talking about gratitude for the past few weeks. If you remember, gratitude is letting others know you see how they've helped you. This is saying thank you to those who have been with you, people like your mom or dad, your older siblings, grandparents, teachers, leaders in your church, or the best friends among you. This is also saying thank you to the people that you see normally all the time. And if I haven't told you already, I'm grateful for you. You make me smile every time I see you, and I just can't keep that happiness inside. So, thank you. You might say that I have the attitude of gratitude, but there are also many different attitudes that we feel every day. Sometimes we have 5 different attitudes before breakfast. But when someone thanks you, or when you thank someone, it can really make your day turn around, can't it? I'm curious, who thinks in this room they can keep from frowning when someone is thanking them? Anyone? Okay, this is what we're gonna do. I want you to take a look at each other and try to make the frowniest face you can make. Yeah, there you go, the frowniest face, that looks good. And then try to say thank you in your most frowniest face. Go ahead, do that. Oh gosh, that is so hard to do. I can't stop smiling. I just can't say thank you. I can't do it, it's so hard. It makes me feel so good to say thank you, especially when I'm thanking God. Having gratitude is, of course, letting those that you love, letting them know how they've helped you, and it's also letting God know how He has helped us in so many different ways, and we can say thank you to Him all the time. The way we meet each week, whether in person or online, helps us to think about how great God is, and that is called worship. Worship is like one big thank you to God. We're telling Him how amazing He is and how thankful we are for all the wonderful things that He has done. And I can't thank God enough. It fills my heart with joy to think that all the amazing things that He has done for me is because He loves me. And I love the words that come from Psalms 136, verse 1. This has been our scripture verse all month. And it reads this, and I want you to read this with me on the count of 3. 1, 2, 3. Give thanks to the Lord because He is good. His faithful love continues forever. Great job. And that is exactly what we're going to talk about today. So join me again this morning as we take another look at Scripture to see how God's love is for us. When Jesus often taught people, He taught by using stories called parables. A parable is a story with a heavenly meaning, and Jesus would use examples and situations from everyday life to help teach a very important lesson about who God was and about who we are, and how can we respond to that. One day, Jesus was telling a story to His closest friends to explain what the kingdom of heaven was like. He explains, there was a man who owned some land, and he needed some help working on it. He went out very early in the morning and he hired some workers to work in his vineyard. As he hired them, the owner agreed to pay them the regular amount for a day's work. Around 9 o'clock later in the morning, the owner went out again to hire some more workers, and he hired the workers and he told them, "I'll pay you what is right." The owner went out again, and around noontime he hired a few more workers, and once again he promised them to pay what was right. Well, all these workers were working in the field, and later on, the landowner had brought out another fresh group of workers, and he told them, I will pay you all the same amount. Around 5 o'clock that evening, the owner went out again, and he saw a bunch of people standing around and asked them why they were just standing there doing nothing. They explained that no one had hired them. So you know what he does? He hires them as well, and they come work in his vineyard too. And now this field is full of workers, all working in this vineyard, and all getting paid the same amount. Later that evening, the owner spoke to the person who was in charge of the workers and said it was time to quit for everybody to go home. But before everybody left to go home, he made sure all of his workers were paid the same amount, starting with the very last person that he hired, going all the way to the first person. And they all got a normal day of pay. Now, you're probably thinking, well, this is really unfair. They all should not deserve the same amount of pay, because not all of them were working the same amount of hours. And they were probably thinking the same thing. And they begin to complain and grumble. They didn't think it was right for everyone, despite how hard they had worked or didn't work, for everyone to get the same amount of pay. But listen to what Jesus says in his story in Matthew chapter 20, verse 13 through 15. He said, "Friend, I am being fair to you. Didn't you agree to work for the usual day pay? Take your money and go. Don't I have the right to do with what I want with my own money?" Now, Jesus made it clear. He wasn't talking so much about worker equality, but he focused on something very important: how God's love is given freely to everyone. Despite how good someone is, or despite how bad someone is, God still chooses to give his love freely to everyone, despite. After all, he does own everything, and he can choose how he shares what he has. And so for us, instead of focusing on what we don't have, we are challenged to adjust our attitudes, that we can choose to look at situations differently and be thankful for the greatness that God is giving us. The truth is, none of us deserve anything. It's not ours in the first place. Everything we have because God shared it with us. And he is generous to everyone, including you and me. And this is how his grace works as well. Not a single one of us deserves grace, but God gives freely his love for us because he loves us. He even loves the people that we don't like the mean people we see on TV or at school. We may not even think it's fair, but if we thought that, we would be no better than the workers that Jesus was describing in his story. So if you're feeling grumpy because someone else has more, remember this: to adjust your attitude. I'll be honest with you, adults struggle with this too sometimes. It's not easy to see others receiving something we feel like that we've worked much harder for. But I have to think about this. Jesus died on the cross for everyone, for everybody, and for every sin. And although we didn't deserve it, he showed his love to all of us by doing so. And he is alive today to tell us that, to give us his spirit, despite how good or how bad we are. And when we think about it, it can help us to have a thankful attitude. Then we can live with joy and gratitude no matter what might be happening around us. But we can still be grateful when we adjust our attitudes. We can focus on what we do instead of focusing on what we think isn't fair. So the challenge is to find a way to be grateful, even when things don't seem fair. I know that seems like a really challenging thing for us, to adjust our attitudes when we think something's fair. But when we do that, we get to express the love that we have. We get to express truly what it means to care for our neighbor. When we take care of them, or show them that we love them, to appreciate the good things that they have, and also be thankful for the things that we have. As we're coming into a season of Thanksgiving, it's a time for us to not so much be thankful about all the stuff that we have, or how much food we have on the table, or whatever, but it's a time for us to give thanks to God. Despite how crazy this year was, we can also be thankful for the good things it was. For the time that we did get to be in school, or the time we did get to see our friends. We can be thankful that we're alive today, that we have air in our lungs, and that Jesus is alive today. Now, before I go, I have one really cool announcement. Parents, you might want to get ready for this. Next week, we're not going to meet like this like we normally do. But instead, for the first time, Unity Kids is going to be live and a part of the normal service. That's right, yours truly is going to be leading the message. And it's going to be a great day, and I hope that you can join us online or in person. So instead of finding a separate video, be looking forward to the service video that's coming up here in the next couple weeks. This week is Thanksgiving, and I want you to keep in mind the things that you are thankful for. Go eat lots of food and have a great week. And if you're meeting with family, be safe and care for those around you. Have a great week, everyone, and I will see you all next week.